coming from JUCO, this is the best experience I had in a long time, you know. Can't complain about anything. I'm grateful.
The relationship I had with Coach Anderson and Coach Cleveland, I knew them before I went to JUCO, and so they was one of the first schools to start recruiting me, so it was really an easy choice. It was just cool to see like a black head coach, and you know, they were family too, and they always preached like the family mindset, so that was always big for me and my family. When I came on my visit, they really just showed me a lot of love. They showed me, you know, I had the opportunity to play right away, and that was something that I really wanted to do. And, you know, they just said they'd give me a chance.
Vince is a scorer. He's a bucket getter. He's a guy that scored at, you know, the junior college level, junior college All-American both years. So this year we had to bring in a guy that can, you know, be able to score for us.
I was blown away at first at how good he scored the ball. Like, I don't think people really know, like, he can really, like, score the ball.
He also can distribute the basketball. Just defensively, I just got to get better. And then, of course, get physically. I think get physically ready for what takes place in the Big East. And that means he got to go in the weight room. He's got to get a few more meals in him.
And JUCO, I mean, I started off 155 and really not knowing how it was to play college basketball. So, I mean, even though it's JUCO, it's still college basketball, and it's still, you still have to play hard all the time and be confident. And so just bringing my confidence level here, that was one thing that really helped me. I always worked hard. So, I mean, I always had that instilled in me. So having that competitive edge and being better than the man I was yesterday, and I'd say that's my main goal. Growing up in the South, I mean, it just teaches you a lot of manners. You know, that was one thing that, like, you know, growing up in the South really is yes ma'ams and no ma'ams. That's one thing you really have to catch on to real quick. Keep your manners in your front pocket. That's really the main thing growing up in the South. Manners can take you places money can't. And so, you know, just always being respectful, always, you know, like I said, having your manners in your front pocket, take you a long way. We had a big family, so to say. My pops, my big brother, my big sister, my little bro, my grandparents, you know, we was a village. Sure. Just the people that believed in me and people that pushed me, I really do it for them so much as I do it for myself. You know, I have a lot of people that, you know, look up to me, my little brother, my mom, my dad. I know they're proud of what I'm doing. I just love seeing them proud. So, I mean, that's my motivation, my family.